I remember him saying, "Don't tell anybody." I remember him saying, "Don't make a sound." Well, hear me now. Using my voice amongst a growing chorus of voices that will not be silenced. Let's make some noise, Australia. I lost my virginity to a pedophile. I was 15, anorexic. He was 58. He was my teacher. For months, he groomed me and then abused me almost every day. Publicly, he described his crimes as awesome and enviable. Publicly, I was silenced by law. Not anymore. Australia, we've come a long way, but there's still more work to do in a lot of areas. Child sexual abuse and cultures that enable it still exist. Grooming and its lasting impacts are not widely understood. Trauma does not discriminate, nor does it end when the abuse itself does. First Nations people, people with disabilities, the LGBTQI community, and other marginalised groups face even greater barriers to justice. Every voice matters. Yes, discussion of child sexual abuse is uncomfortable, but nothing is more uncomfortable than the abuse itself. So let us redirect this discomfort to where it belongs, at the feet of perpetrators of these crimes. Together, we can redefine what it means to be a survivor. Together, we can end child sexual abuse. Survivors, be proud. Our voices are changing history. 11 years ago, I was in hospital, anorexic, with atrophied muscles. I struggled to walk. Last year, I won a marathon. We do transform as individuals, and we do transform as a community. When I first reported, I was shamed and ridiculed by some. But now, my truth is helping to reconnect us. I know who I am. I'm a survivor. A proud Tasmanian.